Hello everyone! In this video you can watch me try to create a nice acrylic bloom again by using the bloom technique. And I tried it before, but I was never satisfied how they looked, because you need the right supplies, consistency, very difficult technique. So I'm going to try it again and see if I can create a nice bloom again. But I'm using the Boom Stain Gel Paints, or Boom Gel Stain Paints again. And they are already mixed, so you can use them right out of the jar. So that's nice. And I think they are made in Australia, but I can buy them here in the Netherlands now, so that's great. What I did first is add a little bit of water to these paints, because they are really thick. And for example, I used 10 milliliters of paint and 1 milliliter of water. And for this base layer, I used 50 milliliters of paint and 5 milliliters of water. So the paints are a little bit thinner because I'm going to use my Lazy Susan. And then you can see also my painting fly in my room. But that's later. So I've added the base layer, and this is the color, I hope I pronounce it okay, Baronia Burgundy. Very nice color. So you don't need a pouring medium for these paints. They are already mixed, so that's great. But if you add water to the base layer, then you also need to add water to your paints, because they need to have the same consistency. But you can use them also right out of the jar. So on top of my base layer, I'm using the Banksia Orange. And on top of the orange, I'm using Sterling Wax White. So you don't have to have a white base layer. You can also have another color. So that's why I chose the burgundy color, because I like it very much. And on top of the white is the Pearl Essence Mint. So it has a nice shimmer to it. I also use these colors on my flower coasters. I will include a link to that video in the right corner. Again, a little bit of the orange. And hopefully I can create a nice bloom. Yeah, and it's all about consistency, but also the cell activator that you pour on top of the colors. And I'm using the Australian Flutrol and Amsterdam Titanium White, but I'm also testing some other paints and mediums that are much easier to buy, but that's for later videos. But the mix of the cell activator, I've used 5 gram Amsterdam Titanium White and 50 gram of Australian Flutrol. There you saw me pour it on top of the colors. And no water. I will include all the mixes in the description box below this video. So the paint mix, but also the cell activator. Yeah, now I'm going to use my hair dryer to blow the cell activator on top of the colors. There I can see it. And I'm already getting some lacing effects. But I'm going to spin, and then you will see my painting fly around in my room. because it's not stuck on my Lazy Susan. There you can see it, but I was lucky because the painting was not damaged. Next time I will tape it onto my Lazy Susan. But the paint is spreading, so that's good. Adding more of the burgundy color because it needs to flow over the sides. And I'm already having some great effects. The colors go very well together. I also created another shade of green. Spin it again. Use my torch to remove some air bubbles. And I'm also going to tilt. And this goes very slowly because the paints are thick. So you need to have some patience. Stretching that lacing. And I'm using a triangle canvas, and this canvas is 20 centimeters, so a little bit larger than the flower coasters I made. Letting it flow over the sides, there you can see it. And tilting it back to the center to stretch the lacing. I think it looks nice. Now I need to work on the sides because they need to be covered totally with this nice burgundy color. So at the end of this video I'm going to show you all a close-up of this painting, but I'm also going to take you all on a ride in our car, and then we are going to do some sightseeing in our neighborhood so you can see how it looks, and not far from my home but close to our home. I'm going to show you what it looks like. I hope you like that all. So, but that's at the end of the video. Yeah, but I can imagine that you can't, that not everybody can buy the Australian Flutrol. But I'm testing also some other materials or supplies. And hopefully I can create the same effects with that. But that's for later videos. And I'm also working on another mixed media project in which I use different supplies to create some nice textures, but also resin combined with resin. So that's also for future videos. And I'm also planning a resin geode again. So a lot of nice videos are coming up. And I'm also very happy. Today I got my new airco system or temperature control system in my new studio. So I can control the temperature that it's not too hot but also not too cold. And I also can control the humidity. So I'm so pleased that I have that now. Because temperature can affect the resin, drying of resin, or if you use resin in a high humidity, then the finish of the resin will not be nice. But also for acrylic paints, if it dries too fast, then you have a risk that the paint will crack. So I'm very happy that I have that system now in my new studio. Yes, and this Boom Gel Stain Paint, yeah, this is the second time I try it, and I tried it also on the flower coasters. I already mentioned that, and I think they are really great. They dry very well with a nice, how do you say that, shine on it. They are not matte. And they dry the way they are, so not darker. I also use the Winsor & Newton paints, and they almost dry very dark, every color of that range of the Winsor & Newton paints. But these paints dry the way they are, so that's great. And I'm getting some other colors of these paints, so I will be also trying them out. Torch again, and then I will show you all a close-up. So this is a close-up right after pouring. Then you can see the effects. So hopefully it will stay this way, because I like it very much. Some great lacing effects, so I'm very pleased with this bloom. And I will let this dry. Maybe I will add a resin layer, I'm not sure yet. And then I will show you all a close-up again. But so far I'm very pleased. Let me know what you think in the comment section below this video. So we are 24 hours later, it's not totally dry, but dry enough to show you all the painting again. I have a little bit of structure there you can see it, too much paint, but I don't mind, I like it. Some great lacing effects, there you can see it. And if I add a resin layer or a varnish layer, I'm not sure yet, then the colors will be much brighter. So I'm very pleased. Let me know what you think. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you like it. And now I will take you all on a sightseeing tour in our car in the neighborhood. So this is close to our home. There are a lot of large houses. And these houses are from farmers. They have cows, or sheep, or horses, but I have a lot of greenery in our neighborhood. This is about 10 kilometers from our home, and I'm showing you as much as I can, but it's very difficult to film in a car. But these are very small villages around the village I live in. I live in a larger village. But these are very small villages, and I like those large houses. But a lot of greenery, so you can see. A lot of trees. And This is how our homes look, the smaller ones. Another part of our area, this is a forest on both sides, but also some grassland on the left side, there you can see it, all from farmers, and on the right side also. I think it's very nice. Some cows on the right side, there you can see it. We have a lot of farmers that have cows for the milk. But I live in the north of the Netherlands, and not in a very big city, but in a smaller town or village. But in the area I live in the biggest village that there is, and these are very small villages with all the greenery around it. There you can see again the cows, very nice. I think it's very relaxing. We do this often too. We ride a little bit in our car and then also get out of the car to drink something in a cafe or something like that, or take a walk. But it's very nice. Smaller bridge, we have a lot of those because we also have a lot of canals, sorry for my English, but yeah. On the right side, a lot of people go fishing always. Now there is nobody there, but normally there are a lot of people that are fishing here. Very nice. Or have some people have small boats, and they again a lot of grass land. Not nice weather today. Yeah, now we need to wait for a boat that is on the canal. Sorry, the bridge is opening, so we need to wait. There you can see it. And there is the smaller boat. A lot of people have these kinds of boats here. Very nice. So I'm very pleased that I live in the area I am in now, because we can go to the forest, or we can go to the center. I'm going to show you also a little bit of the center that is near my home, or we can go to the zoo, the theater, whatever. Yeah, now we are very close to our home again. On the right side, the colorful building is a hotel. So very nice. But this is one of the bigger streets near our home. We need to wait. And now we go to the center part, but also on the left side is the zoo. And on the right side, in a minute, there's the center that I live close to. On the left side is the parking lot for the zoo. The larger building you see on the left side is an elderly home. So they live very near to the center, because on the right side is the center. In one of my next videos, I will show you a little bit how the center looks. And you can see the roof of the zoo again. Now we go to a tunnel. I hope that's an English name. This is also near our home. Very colorful on the sides. And now we need to go left, because that's the way to our home. And we are almost there. So I hope you like this short sightseeing tour in our neighborhood. And for sure I'm going to show you more. What I already mentioned, maybe some of the center. It's also nice. But we are almost home. I'm almost home. And I want to thank you all for watching again. And hopefully, I will see you all in the next video. Bye.